Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today I want to show you 5 tips for drawing precisely in ARCHICAD. Sometimes when you want to draw a wall in the middle of another wall. In this example we will do this. That seems very easy, but we are going to get a problem. Let's say that we have 300 cm wall and gonna place right to here. If we just hover over this wall, you will see that dot in the middle of the wall. As you can see, it was automatically snapped that middle point easily. After coming here, I'm going to create a corner next to this center point. What we are going to do is, we hover over this and make a center line and trim. There you go. We have done this, but we have taken a bit more step. Actually, we will do this very easy. Now, let's just get rid of these walls and I'll show you how. First step is, as we did before, we just hover over this wall and come to here. And this time without finishing the wall, we again hover over this wall too. Then hit the shift key and now we can click here. We have our corner now and we can extend this through the wall. Here is the second problem. We are just going to create another wall in the middle of this empty space. But when we hover over again, it shows us the previous middle point. The long way for doing this, we just go to line tool, this line tool, and create another line between these two walls from here to here. We just hover over that again. We see the point and again the same, hover over this and we can just connect them together. Hit the shift and there we go. I'm sorry, but this was the long and wrong approach. Let's just get rid of these two and I'm going to show you the short way of doing this. In order to achieve it, we just go to window tool and go to palettes and we have this control box over here. If we just open up this control box, you will see something like this. You can duck it anywhere you want. I prefer placing that here. And I'm gonna align these boxes to that. There we go. In this control box, we have a couple of options. For instance, we have half button over here. If we just open up this menu, we can see these divisions, person and distance. At the next of this icon, we have this arrow and this is for snapping options, which we are going to use. You can see this along entire element and we have this between intersection points. From now on, the middle snapping point will be determined by the intersection points, like this. We can directly snap in the middle of any wall from now on. I prefer using this control box. Not only for this, there are lots of options too. Actually, in this example, we won't need any additional walls. Because this was a temple of Mars, maybe we can create an altar room for this building. Anyways, moving on. The next step for the precise working in projects passes from precise dimensions. Let's say that we are going to create an apartment. So let's just go to wall tool and change the wall thickness. Let's make this 25. Hold the shift and input a value here. Let's make this 5 meters and continue with 8 meters and put the same value here for this corner. You just hit the shift and click this corner. There you go, you have a precise rectangle and you can just draw a wall as in the previous example and create another room over here. There we go. Now it's time to measure up these distances. You just hit the M, click here and here. You will see that 160. But I want this 2 meters. So we are going to move this 40 centimeters more. But when you're working like this, you can do small mistakes. The longer but precise method of doing this using grids. The grids icon over here and we have arrow and options under the view and grid editing plane options, these grids backgrounds. We have main grid spacing over here and also aux grid options next to it. Let's make this 100 and also this one too. As for the aux grid, we can make this 10 and also 10 here. Let's try this and go with the OK. Now, when we move our mouse, you will see this black point which follows your mouse. Actually, these are grids. If you go to wall tool and draw a wall, it's going to snap that grid points. And now you can continue making your walls without inputting any value in the keyboard and make your rectangular shapes easier. Generally, this was used for construction elements like axis, but if you just change the snapping distance for the project, it does the trick and you can create your preliminary projects faster and easier. Let me show you how it's going to be act if we change the grid distances. Let's go back to the design, view and grids backgrounds. Now we are going to change the steps. For instance, let's input here 10 and also input here 10. Show construction grid and we have this preview. And we will see that these aux grids will follow the main grids. Firstly, ArcGIS gonna draw the first 100 distances main grids. After that, it's going to create the secondary aux grids. Let's play around this value. Nothing happened. Again, go back to the background and increase the steps. Now it's going to snap. Because of this, ArcGIS will prefer the main grid firstly. If you just hover over your mouse, your black point will be snapped to the intersection points. Now let's change the steps to 0 and these steps to maybe 5 centimeters. Click OK. There you go. Now you can create your project 5 and the multiple of 5 dimensions. Alright, now we can continue the third tip. When you are working in ArcGIS, you can thought that you work with precisely. You measure up some distances in your projects. You just hit the M. But let me just first this construction point off and measure here. We can read over here 343. Continue. And this is 346. Actually, these are not the values that we read now. I'll show you why. Let's go to Options, Project Preferences, and Working Units. We are going to change this centimeters decimals to 1. And now we will see the beyond the comma. Click OK. Let's just hit the M. Measure this up. There we go. Is 342 and 9. Again, let's measure up these distances. It's gonna say 346, and this is going to be 1551.6. If we just works with actually without the comma, you won't see that beyond values. In this example, we have a floor plan, and we have an empty space over here. Now we are going to create an object. Let's go to the object and furniture settings. Place a sofa, for instance this one. Click OK and place here. Let me zoom in a little and move to here. There you go. Now we are going to place here a friend for this. Maybe one person sofa. Let's go back to the options of this sofa and change this to 1. We're gonna make this 95 and click OK. Oops, we would better copy the previous sofa. There we go. And Ctrl plus T. Make this one 95 here. Click OK now. And rotate. Now our problem will be shown up. I want to give here an actual space, which is gonna be 100 centimeters. We just first place to here, and again move to here 1 meter. Now we have a 1 meter space between the wall and the sofa. If we just want to change this, let's go back and input another value. For this, we're gonna intersect this together and again move another 25 centimeters because I want that 25 centimeters. Any problem? The problem is you don't have to do that. There is a shortcut for this. You only need to move this to here with the shift. If you want 60 centimeters distance, you're gonna input here 60 and hit the minus and hit enter. There you go. Now you have 60 centimeters distance. Let's make another example. Let's just place a 25 centimeters distance between these two sofas. Enter move command. Hit the shift. Click the tab. Input 25 and hit minus and hit enter. There you go. We have created 25 centimeters distance. For these chairs, let's input here 45 centimeters. Hit the tab, input 45, hit minus, hit enter. It's pretty nice and sweet. Let's moving on to the our fifth and the last tip for this tutorial. Let's say that you have created these walls and you don't have any doors. Let's simulate that and get rid of these doors. Hit delete. And also this. Now we are going to place our new doors. In order to do that, let's just go to door tool and click here. Sorry, let's change the direction. Maybe somewhere here and determine the direction. Well, you know you need a 10 centimeters distance between the wall and the doors. In order to achieve that, you just move the door to the wall and move another 10 centimeters. As for this corner, this place here and again move another 10 centimeters from the wall, or you can just follow the previous method. Hit the tab, input 10, hit minus and enter. Actually this was better approach. Let's also create here. The third method is clicking another corner to make reference. But you won't be so lucky every time. In this example, our door and basin was intersected. Now we can mirror it and align to here as in the previous example. Okay, let's cut to the chase. Let's just delete all of these doors. You just hit the shift to select multiple and hit the delete. Now you need this control box. In order to open that up, you go to the window and go to palace and you are going to click that control box. But we have here and we're gonna use this distance and input here 10. Here comes the magic. We are just going to hover over the walls with the door and now you will see some dashes on the walls. Yes, as you guess, these are multiples of 10. And we can click on that. As we are doing this, our doors will be placed 10 centimeters away the walls. It's very easy, fast and precise. We are going to hover over the wall and see the dash and place on that. And these were how you can create precise drawings with these 5 tips for ARCHICAD. Okay guys, I hope you liked this video. Please like and please subscribe and have a nice day.